हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू ईसे एकेडमी।
इन दिस लेक्चर लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड डिफरेंट स्टेप्स फॉर फिल्टरिंग इन फ्रीक्वेंसी डोमेन। दिस ब्लॉक डायग्राम रिप्रेजेंट्स द डिफरेंट स्टेप्स दैट आर इन्वॉल्व्ड फॉर फिल्टरिंग इन फ्रीक्वेंसी डोमेन। हियर द इमेज एफ ऑफ एक्स कमा वाई विच इज इन स्पेशियल डोमेन इज प्री प्रोसेस्ड, देन फोरियर ट्रांसफॉर्म इज अप्लाइड ऑन दैट इमेज to get f of u comma v. So this is the Fourier transform representation of the image f of x comma y. For this Fourier transform, filtering function h of u comma v is multiplied to get the function h of u comma v into f of u comma v. Once the processing is done, the inverse Fourier transform is performed to get the value g of x comma y, which is the enhanced image of f of x comma y. So here some pre-processing work as well as post-processing work will be done. Now let us understand different steps involved in this. In the first step, we will take the image f of x comma y of size m cross n. In the second step, to centralize this image, we will multiply the image f of x comma y with the value minus 1 to the power of x plus y. So this work is known as pre-processing. Then Fourier transform is applied on this image to get f of u comma v. So here f of u comma v is the Fourier transform of f of x comma y. So this can be obtained by applying DFT. In the next step, the filter function h of u comma v is considered, which is the filter in frequency domain, and these two values will be multiplied to get g of u comma v, which is equal to h of u comma v into f of u comma v. So that is what it is happening in this step. Then inverse Fourier transform is applied on g of u comma v to get g of x comma y. So in the next step, we'll get g of x comma y by applying inverse Fourier transform. For this, we'll apply inverse Fourier transform. So this image can be written as inverse of g of u comma v, again it is multiplied with minus 1 to the power of x plus y. So this is the final filtered image, or this is the enhanced version of the image f of x comma y. So these are the different steps that are involved in filtering in frequency domain. Hope you have understood the topic. Thank you.